All right, guys, it's going to be the Cup Series, the NASCAR 2006 Total Team Control.
You already know that I got my Tony Stewart hat on. Let's do this.
To the game.
Hi, I'm Elliot Sadler, driving the 38 M&M Ford Taurus.
I'm Dale Jarrett, driving the number 88 UPS Ford Taurus.
We're chasing the Cup.
EA Sports.
If it's in the game, it's in the game.
NASCAR 2006 Total Team Control.
Go win his championship.
Yeah. We're ready.
Jump up! Shoot! The one time, two time, three time, four time! Alright, baby!
Basically, 300 points ahead of Mark Martin and Jeff Gordon right there. 298 ahead of Mark Martin to win this thing. Oh boy. My favorite track, New Hampshire. Yeah, baby. Yeah. My favorite track, guys. Let's go do this. Jason Leffler is horrible. It's back when he had a three-car team. We just got Jason Leffler. It was a two-car team, not three. Last time Bobby Bunn's gonna be in 18 this year. Back in 1916.
New Hampshire International Speedway. This flat 1 mile track is a challenge for driver and crew chief. Setup is a high wire act. The goal? Make the car turn when it really wants to go straight. Today, the stars of the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series face a chassis challenge on a New England summer Sunday. EA Sports welcomes you to the New England 300 at New Hampshire.
And I'll decide if I want to go with 18 PSI or not after this. I'm just ready to go. I know this track all too well, like the back of my hand. Till they repave it again. Or if they get the new car. I'm not in a Dodge this year, I'm in a Chevy Monte Carlo. Track in NASCAR, it's New Hampshire. I like it, but I think I might still do a little bit of tire pressure adjustments here. I'm gonna try 20. I know some of our top speed have gone, but we'll see how it does in the first run. If not too good, we'll bring the PSI back up. It's all about handling mainly here in the turns. That's the key. Stay in the throttle most of the way through the turns. Here we go. Yeah, better handling a little bit. A little bit better handling. like how they went with the further cam. Like in Thunder, they didn't have that far cam, though. Now they just kind of go a little bit more further out. I think I can do this better on a steering wheel, actually. But me turning wouldn't be going so much. Flat part of the track all the way around, it'd be fine. I'm the only one friend in 29 second lap so far, that's for sure. This track all too well. I just think it's going to be a cakewalk. The only win we're going to get this week comes in the top level, but it's at my best track. That's the thing. It's at my best track. Might be able to get in the 20. We're going to get in the 28s for sure. At some point today, we'll be in the 28s. Be a 28 second lap right here, guys. I almost said 27. I don't know about no 27 second lap. Yeah. Up 29 still. I'm so close to it. Maybe this one. Starting to get more bumps into the track though now. Sip of tea right now, to be honest with you guys.
the middle line and then even go back down to the bottom. Go to the bottom, to the middle, to the bottom, all the way through here. Not even hurting the tires. That's the thing I love about this track. It's so unique. Now, Kenny Irwin Jr. lost his wife here in 2000. Same thing with Adam Petty. The throttle's hung. Didn't even lose any time. Just keep on trucking. Lost about a hundredth of a car. That's about it. Tenth and a half, yeah, that's about it. Still over a tenth and a half faster than speed. We're about two or three tenths faster every lap in the field. Every single lap. So on the hardest difficulty, and this ain't but lap. Really, lap 14. And we're already 4.5 seconds ahead of the field. Like NASCAR Thunder 2003, where I can already start to see some of the lap cars up there. It's usually flat 25. But if I get to see some lap cars soon, I want to go through them one by one, nice and easy. NASCAR Thunder 2003 and 2004, I'll see the lap cars by lap 25 up ahead of me. And find out if that's the case here or not. We're gonna dodge for a little bit. Now back in the shade for the first time since the Thunder series. So. When they repaved this in 2003. Same pavement for Thunder 2004, 2005, Chase for the Cup, and now 06 Total Team Control, same pavement. In 2000, 2001, it just had a little bit repaved on the bottom down here, just this bottom right here is repaved, but there ain't really no difference between. There's a little bit of difference because the cars are different now for this track. Recently, but still basically the same track. They repaved it in 2002 and it's still, or 2003 and it's still the same right now, so I'm having problems with it. Hope they never repave it. They'll repave it in 2011, so. That's why I won here in NASCAR 2011, because it's right before they repaved it in 2012. We can get some entertainment for you guys pretty quick. With some lap traffic. Hardest difficulty, you see, I didn't even practice this when I didn't qualify because I knew we had the car. I know this track all too well. Don't turn quite as hard. Save your tires like that. I didn't make the AI a little bit stronger either. They're just all more packed together, not really fanned out and packed. So they're starting to get a little packed there, though. Started getting three packs, looks like. Hope we can see that backpack pretty quick. Like I said, by lap 25, you just see them. Somebody almost wrecked right there. Still don't see them yet. Might have saw a tip of car. Let's see if we can find some lap traffic up there. Let's see if we can see them this time. We come out of one and two. Come out of two. Is there any lap traffic? Still don't see them. I might have saw one there for a second. We'll see. Still don't see him yet. Like Cal Larson, North Wilkesboro here. Definitely done live the most. I think we're gonna have to worry more about fuel for tires. And I'm pretty conservative though here. As you see, I'm just now at halfway on fuel, and some of the cars already pitted. So they're gonna be lapped already. Yay. I'm just gonna ride out here as long as I can. My best track, so it's like I'm just the best at New Hampshire. The Magic Mile is magic to me. I'm the Magic Man, I guess you could say. I'm the Magic Man. You might call my YouTube channel, call me the Magic Man. I am the Magic Man. So that's just the cold hard truth right there. My finger's starting to get a little bit sore from holding my throttle down for so long. Yeah. So I might be trying some strategy here because I'm just checking out so hard on it. Start seeing tire wear in about another five, maybe not even to another 10 laps, so I'm the best on tire wear here and everything. It's kind of like if I'm riding around, basically, where I can go through these corners. And I'm super fast on the straightaways around here. Transition here never changes. You see a lot of cars up there now. Just as relaxed and cool as a cucumber. I've been wanting to pass some cars. Finally, I have a chance here. Come on. And
pass some cars on the green. That's what we want. That's what I want. Yep, we don't have to worry about fuel before tires. About 25. One pit stop race. It should even about even. It should wear about even. Car still just as fine, Danny, as it was when it was brand new, baby. It's out for a little Sunday drive. That's all. Nice joyride. Car still, it's brand new. Little high there, but no problem. A little bit out of the racing groove there. Lost a little bit of time. No big deal. Yeah, we got over 7.5 plus seconds right now. That's what I'm talking about. We're saving our ears. So we'll put four on from now. If you can't steer here, you're screwed. Tires can last profit by another 15, 20 laps. I doubt anybody else can last that long though. Except for, of course, the ones that just pitted. Randy Dandy, the magic man. Have a shot to pass on the green, hallelujah. My prayers were answered. What's up, buddy? Bye, buddy. That wasn't fun. That was a boring pass. Yeah, I'm kind of like Mark Truex Jr. though, too. I'm a boring winner. Every time I do win a race, I dominate. So. Might as well cut the TV off because you already know he's going to win. This past couple more, come on. Got a 9 second lead and come down pit road. Nearly half speedway over the leaders. Up there, fuel is on red instead of on orange. I go by another 3 laps. Try to lap the field today, that'd be nice. I almost lapped the field here once, I still haven't done that yet. Either Jimmy Johnson or Martin Martin was the only one else on the lead lap, or it might have been Matt Kennedy. The only thing, my fingers start to get tired, but I'm going for it.
Go.
Yeah, thanks for the dent. The only dent or donut I got on my car is just from Arrival. Terry Labonte, thank you. I'm on Buffett out, though. In this pit stop, because I want a clean car, if possible. You know, I might get caught by a lot of rivals. Let's see. See, if I didn't have no rivals, though, if everybody was normal, or even an ally, possibly, or allies probably wind up getting hit, but if everybody was normal, I have a clean car all the way through this. No doubt. Wow, oh, we just slide way up. Go by me, go by me. Or don't. Okay, well, he's pitting. Okay. Everybody's going by. My bad. I like the way the car is. I could even take two tires, but well, our tires are worn even. Yeah, we need these. 25 to go now. 26 to go. Everybody's going to take a four. Some of you guys are going to chew up now with them this morning. We might not lap the field today, but we did awesome. I want to eat some whiskey glasses. You're instantly up to track speed just like that. We're going to go hard now, though. We're going hard now. Boogity, boogity, boogity. Rock and roll. Now you'll see those awesome. Now it's going to get interesting the rest of this race. You'll get to see my actual maneuvers now at this racetrack and why I'm known as the Magic Man of the Magic Mile. Damn, smooth maneuver.
Don't get a 28-second lap. It's going to be one of these right here. I'm racing for that Sunday money. It's the closest 28 you're going to get right here. Oh, so close. Hello, Rusty. He's trying to get a side draft and he's slowing me down, though. Slowing me down, none at all. Side draft ain't gonna help here. Can't really do this. Bye-bye. Smooth maneuvers. Just racing down. This is a victory right here, though, out of everything that's happened this week. This will be the victory right here. Complete shutdown of the field. Hallelujah. Amen. Wish there was 50 to go, though, instead of 25, man. I could have whooped some booty. If it was 100 laps instead of the 75, oh, man, I would have lapped the field. A lot of you fellow racers and YouTubers out there are watching what I'm doing right now. Taking y'all to school, showing y'all how it's done. It's starting to get a little more bumps than it used to. For teammate Jason Leffler, he's already a lap down, about to go two laps down. Maybe even three, though, depending on if he was that first group of cars that pit earlier. Somebody's out of the race. Pit road there. Trader just opened the door for me. Thank you, bud. Bye-bye. At some point, they might get in. This money right now, domination all the way again. I'm the roller. Actually, I lapped the whole field here in the Busch series. Yeah, I'm coming through. I'm a roller, I'm a rider, I'm number one mother trucking survivor. Back to Thunder days right now. Nothing like the good old Thunder days. Good old NR Thunder days. Oh, wow. Well, thank you. Sterling Marlin? Can you tell me that I'm clear? Thank you. Didn't get any damage to slice contact. Thank you a lot, though. Spotter. Traffic while the rest of the field isn't. Like, see how many cars on the lead lap. We're going to look at everything. Be a 29-second lap right here. Come on, baby. Oh, it's the 29. That's the fastest lap of the day right there. 28, it might be as much as possible. That might be a record right here. If we can get 28, I want that 28-second lap. Might be the last time right here because we don't have lap traffic to deal with for the rest of this race. Side draft from Jeff Green might slow us up. We did it, 28. There we go. We done it. We have accomplished our goal. 28.982 second lap. We've done it. Turn it hard all the way and let off turn hard all the way. It's probably possible. Just kind of bump. Can we do it again? It's got to be this lap if possible. Did it again. 6.4 that time. Not 8, but 6. We went from 2/10 to another 2/10 right there. Going faster and faster now. 0, not getting much room. That's Truex. Martin Truex Jr. Bump a little bit. This ain't going to be fastest lap though right here. 29.013 though. Whoa. Getting around these cars drafting and helping me push through. Yeah, our lap times are slowly deteriorating now, though. Like we've done all we can do. Jeff Burton right there. Oh, well, I might see a wreck here. Another, the fastest lap now, a 28.927. We're going to go for it all the way. As much as we can, we're going for it. We got one more lap as well. We got a rival in front of me. I don't know if this just lift right here be the safest way, though. Without contact from Harvick, stay low. Nope, he's gonna want to hit me. He's wanting to. Oh, the five. I use them as a pick. A perfect veteran move to the line. Is it the fastest lap of the day? I think it was. I think it was. I started in the eight. It was like right out of nine. That was the fastest lap right there, the last lap. Yes! How many cars on the lead lap, though? I was driving the wheels off that thing into the very end. Greg Biffles, Jimmy Johnson back in fifth. Mark Martin, I don't even see him up there. Car lifters. Where does everybody else finish? I led 74 of the 75 laps. Who led the other one? That must have been under caution. It had to be. Yep. Michael Waltrip with a top 10 and started third. Way to go for Michael Waltrip. Finally back up there. Way to go, Mikey. And they were talking about literally the double zero Aaron Dreams machine. Mikey Waltrip with a career day for 2005. Bob Bonney started 10th, finished 13th. So, there was 16 drivers left on the lead, left on the lead lap. Kurt Busch, I left him down, and Kevin Harvick, that's the last two right there. One started. Woo. Travis Popple in this thing. Got a good start for Travis from the Truck Series. Made some practice there. Where in the world? There's Sterling Marlin right back there. Where is? Let's get this. There. There's Mark Martin, finished 12th. .180 compared to Mark. We gained 60 points in that race. Here's the highlight reels real quick. And there's the last one. Look at that. Right around them on the bottom. Bye-bye. Checkered flag, baby. Hell yeah. Victory lane. But our teammate, Bobby Labonte. Another one of Tony Stewart's great tracks, Pocono, baby. Hell yeah! Yeah! See you guys next one. Peace out.